Hello there, a good day. Another day is there in the life of the world, and it's good to know that we are all still driving safely to stay alive and be protected, more so that the COVID-19 pandemic is still here with us. It's time to talk safety on our roads again on the Our Road Safety Educative Program on TV, Trace FR, courtesy Ogun State Traffic Compliance and Enforcement, called Trace, an agency of government that is charged with the administration and control of road traffic matters. Now, today's package promises to be educative and informative as always, because all the segments that makes up the program are also included in today's package and will be served presently after this timeout. I am Babatunde Akinde. Welcome on board.
To all road users in Ogun State, do you know that you are only as valuable as the value you place on your life? The Ogun State Traffic Compliance and Enforcement Corps, Trace, wants you to know that life has no duplicate, because we are only fulfilled when you get to your destination safely. That's why we say, don't make or receive calls while driving. Speed kills, discourage your driver from going beyond specified speed limits. Don't distract, and don't be a distraction to other road users. Don't overload your vehicle with goods and passengers. Okada riders should put on and fasten their crash helmet always, and must not pick more than one passenger at a time. Truck and trailer drivers should have consideration for other road users, because the road belongs to all. Trace, safe and responsible driving, a must.
Welcome back. Let's get the show started now with the safety tip segment. And our focus today is on road traffic signs.
Safety tips on traffic regulatory signs. Traffic signs generally are signs erected at the side of the road or above the road to guide motorists, motorcyclists, tricyclists, pedestrians, and other road users about traffic regulations, special hazard, and road conditions. An understanding of traffic signs is required for all road users to have a safe journey. Every road user must not only be familiar with each of these signs, but must also recognize the special shapes, colors, and meaning of these signs. Regulatory signs are basically classified into two. 1. Prohibitive signs. 2. Mandatory signs. Prohibitive signs are usually circular in shape with yellow or white background, black inscription, and red border. They are regulatory signs that give instructions that are prohibitive in nature, such as no right turn, no left turn, no U-turn, no waiting, no on, no entry, no parking, no stopping, maximum speed limit sign, give way to traffic on your left sign, overtaking prohibited sign, etc. The stop sign is a prohibitive sign that is octagonal in shape with red border and yellow or white inscription with border respectively. You should come to a complete stop anytime you see this sign. The second type of regulatory signs, which are called mandatory signs, are usually circular with blue background, white inscription, and sometimes with white border. These signs give positive instruction like U-turn sign, keep right sign, roundabout sign, diversion sign, two-way sign, minimum speed limit sign, temporary stop sign for traffic control, head of diversion sign, pedestrian track sign, compulsory circle track sign, priority to approaching vehicle sign, etc. Traffic signs tell you about traffic regulation, special hazard, and road conditions. Be familiar with them and always make use of them to have a safe drive.
To all road users in Ogun State, do you know that you are only as valuable as the value you place on your life? The Ogun State Traffic Compliance and Enforcement Corps, Trace, wants you to know that life has no duplicate, because we are only fulfilled when you get to your destination safely. That's why we say, don't make or receive calls while driving. Speed kills, discourage your driver from going beyond specified speed limits. Don't distract, and don't be a distraction to other road users. Don't overload your vehicle with goods and passengers. Okada riders should put on and fasten their crash helmet always, and must not pick more than one passenger at a time. Truck and trailer drivers should have consideration for other road users, because the road belongs to all. Trace, safe and responsible driving, a must.
Welcome back. I just gone by there before the interlude was the safety tip segment, which today focused on road traffic signs. And joining me on the discussion segment to further pick this issue to pieces is the PRO of the Vehicle Inspection Office, Ogun State, and that's in person of Commander Olukayode Solomon Abati. Commander Abati, a good day and welcome to Trace Afar.
Good day.
All right, let's start from here. What are road traffic signs?
Well, road traffic signs are the signs erected by the site or above the road to give signal to road users.
Okay.
And apart from that, they are in place. I mean, the signs are in place to give smooth and safe traffic flow on our roads.
Okay, there are signs, maybe signs or a warning, so to speak. It may also be in form of markings, as it were, erected above or even on the road itself to give direction. Now, what are the classification of road traffic signs?
Yeah, we have a lot of them. I will start with warning lights.
Okay.
We have warning lights. We have regulatory signs.
Okay.
We have informative signs. We have the pavement markings. So we have the cone, and we have the what is it called? The rope.
Okay.
So we have various types of signs on our roads.
Okay, for the benefit of the motoring public that are watching us now, I know you brought some of these signs.
Yes, sir.
Okay, maybe I should start this way. What are the shapes and color components of some of these road traffic signs?
Well, like I said earlier, we have warning signs. The warning signs, they are triangular in shape.
Okay.
So they are triangular in shape with a yellow background,
okay,
white inscription, and a red border.
Okay.
So this is
maybe they are still by the time we come back, I think they are still showing us some of the signs which the government has just erected on some traffic corridor within the Abeokuta metropolis. What our viewers are watching is along the Nepo Road. Along the Nepo Road, Shapon Imo access, which has now been regulated. Package there should be has been regulated to a particular lane, so that people do not create unnecessary issues for those that are using the access. Maybe when we, I think, if the producer is listening, let's come back to the studio so that the PR. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, let's start with the regulatory sign. You explained the regulatory sign.
I've just explained the warning sign.
Okay.
So from the warning sign, so there's another one called the regulatory signs. That regulatory signs, they are circular
in shape. Okay.
With a yellow background, white inscription, and red border.
Okay. Do you have it here?
Yes.
For the benefit of our viewers. Okay. Anytime you see a sign like this, these are regulatory signs.
This is regulatory sign telling you no entry.
Okay. Is it prohibitive or mandatory? This should be prohibitive.
Prohibitive.
Okay, because another regulatory also has prohibitive and mandatory.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. This is prohibitive sign.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
The same thing with no parking signs.
Okay.
No parking sign. So they are regulatory signs. But the one I mentioned earlier, the warning sign, they are triangular in shape.
Okay.
Yes. So apart from this one, we have informative signs.
All right.
They are rectangular in shape.
Okay, rectangular.
Rectangular. Okay. They are like a box.
Yes.
And they have a green background with white inscription. And the meaning of that is to tell you when you are approaching an airport, seaport, filling stations, hospital, you will see it by the side road.
Just to inform you
that in the next few minutes you are likely to get to this area. That is informative. Apart from that, we have the pavement markings, and those are the markings we put on the road, either to demarcate the road into two or for the people crossing, like the zebra crossing. So okay. It's usually black background. You know, the pavement is always black
and
with white
stripes,
inscription okay. on it. And apart from that, we have another one we call the cone. So that cone, we place it on the road to demarcate or to inform the road user that there is a problem
ahead.
You understand it? And apart from that, we have what we call a cordon rope. Cordon rope.
Okay.
So you can get all those ones at the when there is traffic crash and at the construction site to tell people there's construction going on in this area, don't move very close.
Okay.
So those are the signs we have.
Okay. Let's talk about the motoring public, particularly the driver now. What would you say is the expectation of a driver anytime he sees or observes a road traffic sign on the road? What is he expected to do?
They just have to obey the traffic sign without any hesitation. Because the signs are there to guide you what you should do and what you should not do. So anytime they see all these signs on the road, they just have to obey them.
How do you feel if a driver does not observe a road traffic sign?
And that is what we are trying to guide against now. You understand? Because if you are not conversant with all these roads, all these signs, you cannot have a driving license. At that point, we sit them down and educate them.
Okay.
Because from the driving school, they have to come back to the VIO, who will conduct the test.
Okay.
So, and at that point in time, we put them through all these questions. If they are not conversant with all these signs, they cannot have a driving license nor drive on our road.
All right, Commander Abati, how well will you say the motoring public, particularly the driver, how well will you say is able to interpret? Because it's one thing for you to know it. It's another thing for you to be able to interpret it so that you can know what it's telling you. How well will you say drivers are able to interpret signs, road traffic signs on our road?
Yes. Our agency, we are working on that. And that's just the reason why we came up with this idea of VIO road sense. You know, many cannot read. And that is the reason why we have this disc.
Okay.
It's a video.
Okay.
It's like watching a movie. So that when they get back up, they will just insert it and watch it. All the road signs, they are there. So I will believe this one will help our drivers and the Okada riders the more. Many of them cannot read.
Okay.
But when they insert the video, they will get everything and they will know what they need to do at the right time.
So from what you just said, I can deduce that you'll agree with me that most of them cannot interpret some of these signs.
Yes.
And it's good you have this. This is more like a public enlightenment drive from you, from the VI office, courtesy the Ogun State government. I know I should also thank the Ministry of Transportation for helping to facilitate this, and the government of the Prince Dapo Abiodun administration, so to speak. Because even if there are signs are being erected in strategic positions in Ogun State now, I can tell you of Abeokuta and Ijebode. It's an ongoing process. In Abeokuta, you see it along the Nepo Road, whereby parking has been regulated to a particular section of the road. We also have it in NNPC. We have it at Chapon. It's an ongoing thing. So we want to implore the general public, particularly the motoring public, to please observe and also interpret these road traffic signs that has been mounted to guide and equally regulate our movement, so that there will not be hitches and crashes here and there. Maybe for the benefit of the motoring public, maybe you should please pick to pieces these signs, as it were. Let's start with the warning sign. What does the warning sign tells the motoring public?
As earlier explained, the warning signs, they are triangular in shape. and they are telling you anywhere you see the sign, you just have to obey it. For example, this one I'm holding is telling you that an aged person is crossing the road.
Okay. An aged person is crossing the road, so yes, please take it easy
on the road. You allow them to
go.
To go.
Okay.
This one telling us there's dangerous double bend
ahead. So take it easy.
Take it easy.
Okay.
This next one telling us a narrow bridge ahead.
Okay.
No, this is not a narrow bridge. This is why carriageway narrow.
Okay.
So this is an entry point.
Okay.
It's widening, and the other side is very narrow. So you have to be very careful.
Okay.
So this is an intersection.
Okay, as you're approaching an intersection.
Intersection of minor on major road. This is a major road.
Okay.
If you are coming from this place, this is minor.
Okay. So entering into a major
road. A major road.
All right.
And this is the general danger sign, popularly called sea caution, that we place on the floor when we have a breakdown with our vehicles. And this one is no entry.
No entry. Anywhere you see this mounted, you
no
can't enter.
Entry. So that's for the warning signs. Then the regulatory signs. Like I said, they are circular in shape. Yellow background. So
what does that one imply?
This is
no parking.
No parking.
Okay.
Anywhere you see this sign, you cannot park your vehicle in that area.
Okay.
And this one is talking about the speed limits.
I can see that.
Your speed should not exceed
100 kilometer per
100.
All right.
This is no waiting.
Okay, no waiting.
And then no U-turn. You cannot make a U-turn.
Anywhere you see that sign.
Anywhere you see this sign, you cannot make a U-turn. And this is roundabout.
Okay.
Telling you you are approaching a roundabout, so you have to
take it
slow down. This is narrow bridge.
Okay, narrow bridge.
Narrow bridge. And then this is no overtaking sign.
You cannot overtake.
You cannot overtake.
Anywhere you see this.
Anywhere you see this. So you cannot overtake.
Okay. Okay. Well, I want to thank you, Commander Solomon Abati, for coming. He's the PRO of the Vehicle Inspection Office, Ogun State. And I want to implore the general public, particularly the motoring public. How can they get this? How can they get this one?
It's available in all our units.
Okay.
In all our commands.
In
Ogun State.
Okay. And how much do you need to pay? Is it free?
No. You have to pay a token.
A token, okay. Okay, well, you need
so
to
visit any of the
VIO offices in Ogun State.
It's available there.
I think we are recommending this for all motorists, be you a motorist, a tricyclist, a motorcyclist, please endeavor to have this. This will help you in knowing most of the road traffic signs that you need to know to make your journey safe and equally as sound as it were. Thank you very much for coming. We hope the next time we call on you, you oblige our request.
I will do that.
All right, it's Interest Afar. After this time out, we'll be going straight to the Vox Pop segment. Stay tuned.
This is our regulatory sign.
The regulatory signs are the signs that tells you what to do and what not to do on the road. The signs are supposed to have been learned by a driver, at least from the roadworthy passbook, the notebook. If you have gone through driving school, at least, and you have gone to VIO's office, at least all these ones, at least you have been given, you will have read them.
Can you please tell us some of these signs, sir?
For example, at least when you are going on the road, we have the zebra crossing, which says that once you get there and people are waiting, you should stop. It's not for them to even wave down for you. But in these days, particularly in Abeokuta, even if a person should step there and a vehicle is coming, if he's not careful, maybe the next place is going to be hospital or mortuary. Then there is always the U, either cross, which tells you not to turn. But these days, people do all kinds of manner of things just as they like. Then there is the crossing. If it is there, it's telling you don't stop in that place. But what happened these days? People will just stop. And when they are accosted, they'll be telling you, I didn't see it. I wanted to just buy something beside the road. That, you see, there are a lot of all these things that are on our roads. But most motorists are so much in a hurry. And some are ignorant, and some are not even aware of it.
Good day, and you're welcome to the Choice News of the Week. My name is Kehinde Adekoya. In its endeavor to upgrade the human capacity development of its workforce, the Ogun State Traffic Compliance and Enforcement Corps, Choice, has commenced its quarterly in-house intensive training program for all divisional commands in the state. According to the Area Commander, Training and Public Education, Choice Corps Headquarters, Commander Olabode Abdul, the training has become pertinent in the view of the ever-changing environment we work in, more so that the only constant thing in life is change. He emphasized that training and retraining, whether internal or external, goes a long way in upgrading and updating human knowledge with new techniques on how best to handle challenges, especially in a technological-driven age. Commander Abdul admonished the operatives to take full advantage of the opportunity the training affords to enhance their capacity and capability for effective service delivery to be achieved. Nevertheless, he saluted their selflessness, commitment and dedication to duty in spite of glaring challenges. Some of the divisions so far visited for the training includes Abeokuta Division, Ewekuru, Ifo, Odeda, Ilaro, Obantoku, Roundo Maitu and Owode Ijako Division. In another development, in its determination to make road users effective and efficient users of the road, the Choice Divisional Command, OTA, has organized a training program for Just Ride store drivers as part of its outreach, training, retraining and recertification of drivers in the state. Facilitator of the training program, Commander Adekunle Ajibade, Area Commander, Ogun State West District, represented by Commander A.M. Oyebola, Head of Operations, Choice Divisional Command, OTA, educated the drivers on human errors in driving and its consequences, defensive driving, as well as night travels and dangers inherent. Commander Oyebola urged the drivers to see themselves as the only sane drivers on the road and ensure they are emotionally, mentally, psychologically and physically balanced before setting out on any journey. On the entourage of the training crew from Choice Divisional Command, OTA, are Commander Temitayo Ojo and Commander Bakrim Nojim. And in the spirit of XP, the call for the promotion of synergy as well as collaboration in order to enhance the safety and security of the citizenry, the unit command, FRSC, Idiroko Unit, Assistant Corps Commander Akinwumi Olaluwoye, has paid a familiarization visit to Commander Akim Adeleye, Divisional Choice Commander, Agbara Division. Commander Olaluwoye praised and commended Choice Corps activities in Agbara and environs in spite of the road and security challenges around the axis, while seeking for other areas of cooperation and understanding to further guarantee the safety of road users within this axis. Commander Olaluwoye requested for the assistance of the Divisional Choice Commander, Agbara Division, Commander Akim Adeleye, in securing an FRSC office in Agbara. In his remarks, Commander Adeleye thanked Commander Olaluwoye's unit commander, FRSC Idiroko Unit, for the courtesy visit and assured him of Choice Corps Agbara Division's support and collaboration in promoting the safety culture in Agbara and indeed the Ogun State Traffic Corridor. And that ends the Choice News of the Week. The rest of the program continues shortly. My name is Kehinde Adekoya. Thank you for watching.
to all road users in Ogun State. Do you know that you are only as valuable as the value you place on your life? The Ogun State Traffic Compliance and Enforcement Corps, TRACE, wants you to know that life has no duplicate, because we are only fulfilled when you get to your destination safely. That's why we say, don't make or receive calls while driving. Speed kills, discourage your driver from going beyond specified speed limits. Don't distract, and don't be a distraction to other road users. Don't overload your vehicle with goods and passengers. Okada riders should put on and fasten their crash helmet always, and must not pick more than one passenger at a time. Truck and trailer drivers should have consideration for other road users, because the road belongs to all. Trace, safe and responsible driving. I'm out.
Welcome back, and that's been our package today. But before we go, let's continue to uphold and equally conduct ourselves with all COVID-19 safety protocols and guidelines. Is meant for you and I to be alive. I am Babatunde Akinbi. See you next week.